with moderator Kevin Ogle, along with Mike Turpin and Kirk Humphries.
Good morning and welcome to Flashpoint. What is going on with the Republicans and former Senator Chuck Hagel, who has been tabbed by the president to be the new Secretary of Defense? He's a former war vet. He is a Republican. But a lot of Repubs are having trouble with him right now. And the irony is, the president can't get this nomination up for a vote, but yet the Democrat, John Kerry, who ran against President Bush, sails through with votes from Republicans and Democrats on that. We're going to talk about that on Flashpoint. Also, our guest today, there's a big bill out at the State House right now. It's the tobacco wars, basically. And our guest is Dr. Murali Krishna. He is the president of the Oklahoma State Board of Health. We're going to be talking to him about this bill out at the state capitol that the governor is behind and big tobacco is on the other side of the fence. We're going to see what's going on with that, what it means to you, and what you think about the controversy coming up on Flashpoint. First of all,
man, Chuck Hagel, you teed it up perfectly.
Well, I'm going to let you guys knock it down the fairway there.
Okay, I don't know about that.
Let's take a look at what it looked like on Friday. Okay. Chuck Hagel and the nomination process. Things are going slow there. Here's how Chuck Todd saw it.
Come on, Chuck, hang in there.
The president. The yeas are 58. The nays are 40. One senator announced present.
With that Senate vote, Chuck Hagel came up short of a 60-vote filibuster roadblock that Senate Republicans demanded, delaying what could still be Hagel's eventual confirmation vote by at least 2 weeks. President Obama was emphatic in his defense of his embattled nominee.
Chuck Hagel, who richly deserves to get a vote on the floor of the Senate, will be confirmed as our defense secretary. It's just unfortunate that this kind of politics intrudes at a time when I'm still presiding over a war in Afghanistan.
Some Republicans want more time because they say Hagel hasn't provided enough information on speeches he gave in the last 5 years. Others say they want more information from President Obama about Benghazi, something the White House provided in this letter Thursday. But ultimately, Hagel's issues with his former GOP colleagues are personal.
There's a lot of ill will towards Senator Hagel because when he was a Republican, he attacked President Bush mercilessly and was very anti his own party and people. People don't forget that.
Well, apparently John McCain didn't forget that, and others as well. Now, he's going to get a vote. I mean, right, in a couple of weeks.
Got a vote on Friday.
Well,
but hey, you know,
that was a vote to bring.
I don't agree with John McCain on everything.
Yeah.
But you know what? Life in the club, in the Senate.
Yeah.
Life's tough on a maverick. John McCain would find that if he ever had to get 60 votes in the Senate.
That's true.
Okay? That's well put.
But Hagel was a maverick Republican, and the Republicans don't want President Obama putting a maverick Republican in there who disagreed with President Bush on the surge in Iraq, and who has a poor record of support for Israel. Those are the things that bother Republicans, and they're not going to fall in line for Hagel.
Yeah, yeah. You know, I kind of want to call up there to Washington, D.C. and get John McCain on the phone and say, you just lost the last election, Senator. You lost to Obama, and then somebody else lost to Obama. He's won two straight.
Does that mean Obama has a dictate and he can do whatever he wants?
Oh, it means that elections have consequences. And
I've heard that, Mike.
Well, no, but even when Bush won, I had to learn to live with that. Now, well, this guy won. Let me say one thing. I got to use a movie analogy.
Cloture has consequences, too.
Yeah, yeah. I hear you. Movie analogy. John, as we're getting older, Kevin, you're like Dorian Gray forever.
No,
50 Shades of Dorian Gray, right here. Yeah, but Kirk, we're getting old. I shouldn't say this, but I think John McCain.
Are you going to quote Atticus Finch?
No, John McCain. I'm quoting a movie here. John McCain's starting to look like the grumpy old man up there. Grumpy old man.
Well, nothing new there.
He's against everything. He's against this. He's against the president. He's against fellow Republicans because they're not good enough Republicans. Really? I mean, come on. Who gets to pass that litmus paper test? He's a Vietnam vet. Who is?
Mike.
John McCain?
Mike.
Show us Chuck Hagel.
Votes have consequences.
Gotcha.
And when Hagel was a maverick in the Senate and didn't support President Bush on the surge, that has consequences.
Yeah.
McCain's told the truth there.
Yeah.
People don't like what he did, and now they're not going to support him.
But you understand? We want to see more of your speeches. Bring your speeches in here.
Oh, his speeches are the problem, man.
We want to know more about Benghazi so we can use Benghazi against Hillary Clinton.
Benghazi's a lot of what this is about.
The whole thing's a filibuster.
The truth is the administration has not been forthcoming on Benghazi, nor has Hillary Clinton, quite frankly.
And,
you know,
What's Hagel got to do with that, though?
He's got everything to do. It's politics, Mike. It's Washington. That's politics.
We got nothing else to argue about. He admitted it's just politics. Give the president the man he wants.
Apparently that's what's going on.
They're not supposed to roll over, Mike.
You need a strong opposition
Give Adolf
voice.
What he wants.
Come on, man. Even, we got a war in Afghanistan, and we want to play politics.
Even Glenn Coffey, the Republican, who was chief of staff and Senate leader, said it's always good to have a strong opposition voice. He was talking about his friends on the Democratic side of the State House. So that's what's going on. Let's just look at this real quick.
We resolved that, didn't we?
No, because it looks like there's going to be a vote on Hagel probably in a couple of weeks, and it will probably be just a majority vote. And they just need 50 plus one. So does he get nominated?
Oh, yeah.
And if it's 50 plus one, he wins.
Yeah.
He gets confirmed at that point.
We'll see. But don't
expect the Republicans to give you 60.
Yeah.
Probably not get 60, but...
Yeah, but it's going to happen.
It will probably happen.
I think,
We'll tell you a battle is happening. Let's, like you like to say, and Kirk does, let's shrink the universe down to Oklahoma.
Yes, sir.
Because there is a Senate bill right now being considered that apparently has the backing of the governor and the backing of other high-profile people, including our guest coming up on Flashpoint, Dr. Murali Krishna, who's the president of the Oklahoma State Board of Health. It has to do with smoking in Oklahoma. See what you think of it. We'll be back right after this with our guests.
Where there's smoke, there's fire.
Yeah, or the tobacco lobby. How do you ever beat the tobacco lobby? You know what I'm saying?
Might have.
We own Truck Month. As Oklahomans, we earn it every day. Find out why Ford F-Series is the number one choice in every industry. Across this country, we own work. And they come in handy on weekends, too. Working hard, even when you're not. During Truck Month, get a stampede of savings on the number one brand for 36 years. And drive an F-150 4x4 for only $239 a month at your Oklahoma Ford dealer. Check the facts at FordWeOwnWork.com.
I was working in the oil field. Had a car accident. Thrown from a car. Car rolled over me. Basically, it split my leg from my hip to my ankle. If it wasn't for OU Medicine, I'm pretty sure I wouldn't be here today. They got me back into everything, life, family, everything. I'm alive and well.
Thanks for calling Big Tobacco.
Hi, I received this bill saying I owe $547 for smoking-related expenses.
That's correct, ma'am. Smokers miss more work, which costs Oklahoma $1.73 billion in lost productivity per year. Also, smokers get sick, costing another $1.16 billion in medical expenses. In taxes alone, that comes out to about $547 per Oklahoma household.
But I don't smoke.
Whether you smoke or not, every Oklahoman pays the bill.
I'm not paying this bill.
Actually, you already did, and you'll be making the same payment again next year. Thank you for your call.
Hello?
Emergency. You need to be airlifted to the ER.
It's an incredibly expensive way to get to the hospital.
But when you get the bill, it's enough to stop your heart. Why do we pay so much? Find out. A News Channel 4 investigation, Monday at 10. From deployment to employment, come to the Career Fair, February 22nd at the Rose State College Student Union. Veterans are encouraged. Go to KFOR.com/job fair.
Back to the big program. As promised, our guest is Dr. Murali Krishna. Dr. Krishna is the president of the Oklahoma State Board of Health. He's also the author of a new book. It's called Vibrant, to Heal and Be Whole, From India to Oklahoma City is the name of his book. And we're going to be talking to the doctor about that in a little bit. But first, we need to get down to the brass tacks of this Senate bill. Set it up for us, Mr. Turpin.
You take it and run with it. It says right here in the headlines, Oklahoma physicians want local control of smoking rules. So does Governor Fallon. Smoke signal. Oklahoma says Fallon support may make the difference. What are you fighting for? Senate Bill
36.
36. What's it all about?
It's about getting local control regarding smoke-free communities around the state. You know that Oklahoma is one of the highest tobacco-utilizing state in the nation, 47th highest. You know, 25% of our population smoke. And smoking is number one preventable cause of death for all Oklahomans. Here we have 43rd worst record as far as studies, as far as the state of our health. We want to improve the health. This legislation will allow local community to have control over whether to have more smoke-free environments or not.
Morale, Morale was my neighbor for about 5 years, a wonderful neighbor, and a lot of people know Dr. Krishna. One of the things they're going to raise, the smoking lobby is going to raise against this.
Tobacco lobby.
Tobacco lobby is going to say, it's not government's job to tell me what I do with my body. How do you answer that?
It's very easy. You know, if I'm eating too many calories, I'm hurting myself. I'm not hurting you. If I'm smoking, I'm giving to you 7,000 chemical pollutants, including 70 chemicals that cause cancer, including some poisonous substances like arsenic.
Are you talking about secondhand
smoking?
Okay.
That you take it home with you, and your family is affected by it. There are several genes that are permanently altered in you because I'm smoking.
You're saying if you're a non-smoker, but you work with a smoker or around
a
smoker, that's what happens. And you're saying it is not a completely self-inflicted disease.
You're right. And smoking is highly addictive. It takes 6 cigarettes to activate the nicotine receptors in the brain. Mm. So within one pack, the youngster becomes primed for addiction to nicotine for the rest of his life.
And so this bill says what?
It would allow cities across the state of Oklahoma to pass more restrictive ordinances than what state law is. In fact, Oklahoma City, Muskogee, where I'm from, way back when, if we wanted to pass an ordinance to say you can't smoke in a park over there by the swings where all the kids are, a city could pass that. Right now, they won't let us.
So Mike,
the tobacco companies won't let us.
It's local control.
Thank you.
Now, you know, back when I was on the school board, we could pass a policy that said you can't smoke at the football game. You know, and so the school board controlling their property had the right to do that. Why? I mean, quite frankly, why doesn't a city have the right to control the city's property?
So you're for the local control aspect of this bill.
I think he's for us.
I'm careful in making this statement. I don't know if I believe it. I don't know anything that I wouldn't support local control for.
Right.
I mean, government closest to the people is the best government you can have.
Yeah, right. And there we have 7,000 physicians across state. Every one of them support this bill. Every one of them. Every one of the healthcare industry that deal with these devastating health effects on people support this local control. And our businesses are losing $1.73 billion a year because of lost productivity. Absenteeism is 50% higher, and their healthcare costs of smokers are 50% higher. So we are paying for it, on the average about $550 for each head, in terms of taxation, other expenses for each Oklahoman. So all Oklahomans should support local control, and we should support smoke-free environments. And that's the entire intent of the bill, is to let local communities decide for themselves if you really want to have more smoke-free environment or not for yourself. Have a debate locally and local communities and cities.
Are you saying these would be city councils?
Yes.
That will decide, okay, you cannot smoke in a public building anymore, or even a private business, we're not going to allow it.
Yeah. Or a park.
Does it have to do just with public property, or can city councils around the state say, that sports bar over there, you can't even have a separate smoking area?
I think each community will decide for themselves.
Right, but they can say that.
They can say that. Mm-hmm. They cannot say that. They need not say that. You know, most communities that are health conscious will probably do something to help their citizens have more smoke-free environment. Out of all the major cities in the United States, only 6 cities do not have local control. And that's two of the 6 are in Oklahoma City and Tulsa. In the entire United States, 48 of the 50 states in the United States have local control. Only Oklahoma and Tennessee does not have local control.
Why can't we get it done?
We need to get it done.
But why can't we get it done? Who's against it? The tobacco lobby?
I think tobacco lobby is playing a very big role. Last year, the bill was not heard by the senator that's in charge of that committee. This year, it was moved to a different committee, and it's going to be voted on Monday morning at 10:30. Senate Bill 36 and Senator Treat's committee is going to be heard.
And the mayor of the state of Oklahoma mentioned it.
The governor. The governor of the state.
Thank you.
We know mayor's an awfully high office, but governor's probably higher.
You remember being mayor.
I was thinking Patrice.
Patrice Douglas was the mayor,
and she was here, you know, just recently. Governor Mary Fallon, in her state of the state,
you're right,
advocated the passage of this bill. Go ahead, you're working with the governor, right?
Absolutely.
This editorial says, Mike.
Yeah, the editorial says, smoke signal. Fallon support may make the difference this year.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I think that's great to have the chief executive of our state coming clearly in favor of this bill, and that'll give us a much better chance of passing this year. Oklahomans deserve this bill to be passed. You know, we are 43rd in the nation in the health. We want to climb up. We want to become more healthier. This is the single most important bill we can pass this year that's going to affect the health of Oklahomans in a positive way. It's going to save money for every business and every individual and save our health.
And the state spends $1.2 billion a year.
$1.2 billion a year.
On tobacco-related costs.
Okay. Well, what we're going to do
is
we're going to take a break, and we're going to come back and talk about the doctor's book, how it could apply to you. You might be surprised. And again, the invitation is open to the tobacco lobby if somebody wants to come on this show and talk about why they either don't support
local
it
or control.
Right. We'll be happy to have you on. We'll be back right after this.
Those are 105 for the smokers. Come on down, baby.
I got to tell you.
Matthew Perry came to Tuesday. He's been up and he's been down. And this Tuesday, he'll reach nirvana.
I see everything.
I get it. You transcended.
No, your pants, they're see-through.
And then, Smash is back. And critics say it's riveting.
One shot's all we need.
Tuesday, you can't resist Smash with Jennifer Hudson.
It's going to be quite a show.
All new Smash, following a new Go On and the new normal. It all starts Tuesday at 9, 8 Central here on NBC.
Mako is having a half-price sale on our most popular paint service. That's half-off service that will increase the value of your vehicle and have you driving with a newfound sense of confidence. The half-price sale. Going on now. Mako, America's number one paint and body shop.
Are you involved in a legal issue or court battle? Do you require retrieval of vital information from computers, GPS, or cell phones? Alias Forensics can make it happen even if the data has been deleted. We can recover a computer user's internet history and retrace their digital steps. If your company has been hacked, our internet response team can stop a hacker in their tracks. Preserve your critical court data by using our forensic imaging process from the top digital forensic and incident response team in the state. Alias Forensics, call today or go to aliasforensics.com.
Applying for Social Security disability is complicated and time-consuming. Initial applications are routinely denied, requiring you to file for what's known as reconsideration. If that's denied, the next step is a hearing before a judge, although sometimes a hearing can be avoided if the proper evidence is submitted. Each year, Ryan Bisher Ryan, one of the state's largest Social Security law firms, handles hundreds of claims throughout the state of Oklahoma. For over 25 years, when hurt people need help, they call us, Ryan Bisher Ryan.
Nice sandwich.
Sometimes you don't want to get fried. The charbroiled, not fried, codfish sandwich at Carl's Jr.
Back with our guest, Dr. Murali Krishna. He is the president of the Oklahoma State Board of Health. He's here campaigning for the Senate bill to allow local governments to decide if they want to ban smoking in certain areas. You had one more stat you wanted to talk about.
Well, I first of all wanted to say that Governor Mary Fallon lost both of her parents, her mom and her dad, to smoker-related illnesses. My dad died at age 53 smoking four packs of Pall Mall a day. Tobacco took him out. That was the end of his life. So I feel fairly passionate about it as well. And you just said 90%?
Yes.
Tell them that figure, that stat.
90% of the lung cancers are caused by smoking. And in fact, in Pueblo, Colorado, they did a beautiful experiment. They had more smoke-free environment loss. And within 3 years, they found a 41% drop in the heart attacks in that community. In fact, 27% within a few months, a drop in the heart attacks. And Mayo Clinic did a study with 144,000 people in Olmsted County, and what they found was a 31% decrease in the heart attacks over a period of 3 years.
And a lot of those are societal costs. Yeah. In your health care costs, in your public safety costs, like every time there's a 911 call, ambulance runs, and so does your fire department.
Yeah, good point.
You cut down heart attacks, you cut down those costs.
Right.
Well,
right.
And just to play devil's advocate, I'm not a smoker, never have been.
Yeah.
But for those who do smoke, they may say, I want to smoke cigarettes. If I get diseases from it, that's my problem. It's my choice. What do you say to those folks? And again, we kind of talked about it earlier with the secondhand
smoke.
You're
right. I think they have the right to smoke, and it's an addiction. You know, they're good people that happen to have an addiction to nicotine, and naturally they want to continue their nicotine addiction. And there are wonderful opportunities to get nicotine-free treatment in terms of, you know, quitting tobacco can be a painless process. with, you know, proper guidance. For example, if you want to try on your own to quit smoking, there's a 3% chance you'll be successful. Mm-hmm. If you call the 1-800-QUIT-LINE that State Health Department Tobacco Settlement Trust have in Oklahoma, your chance of quitting smoking would be 33%. Mm-hmm. So we have wonderful help available free of charge for everybody to improve their health. And a lot of the times when a smoker tries to quit, they have withdrawal symptoms. They feel more nervous. They feel more tense. They may feel depressed. You know, they may be irritable. You know, a lot of it is really withdrawal from nicotine. Mm-hmm. And there are ways in which they can learn how to cope with that naturally from their own inner resources. Okay. And that's what they're going to be taught while they're being given some advice how to cope with withdrawal symptoms.
Okay, speaking of inner resources, Dr. Krishna has published a book.
It's a brand new book.
It's called Vibrant, to Heal and Be Whole, pardon me, from India to Oklahoma City. Doctor, what is this book about? What are you trying to tell folks? And what can somebody who wants to get it expect to find out?
It is a book about healing and hope. Every human being experiences adversity, change, and challenge, and losses in our lives. None of us are immune from that. So I have experienced it myself, profound changes, profound adversity from the age of 9. And with my mother's illness, and later on I witnessed our own
illness. What was your mother's illness?
My mother has had a bipolar disease that we did not know at that time what she had.
You know, we were visiting beforehand, and Murali, you mentioned that what's the degree of exposure to mental illness among the population?
25% of the people have mental illness in the United States.
One in four. And you know what? Yeah. That means there are very few families that are not touched by mental illness. My own sister died. She was bipolar, manic depressive, died after years of treatment and medication for that, and finally the medication got out of balance and it killed her 25 years ago. Right. Yeah. And it took me a while to understand that she didn't have a choice in this. Mm-hmm. You know, I kind of grew up as, hey, buck up and get your act together. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Talk about that. It's a disease.
Absolutely.
It's a physical
disease.
A physiological disease.
Absolutely. These are brain diseases. Mm-hmm. Just like you have diabetes, just like you have hypertension, just like you have seizures, allergies, brain diseases, they can be treated, they can be monitored. So I talk about my mother's illness and the devastating effect it had on our family and how we have learned how to cope with it and how to struggle through it and how to find hope in that and how do you heal from it and how do you become whole. Being wholesome means being connected. And I didn't stop there. I learned from our Oklahoma City bombing experience. I was chief of staff at St. Anthony Hospital that helped coordinate with many other physicians relief for our bombing victims and their families. And I witnessed something very miraculous happening. The spirit, the strength of the spirit, human spirit, is abundant in Oklahoma City. In fact, when I go overseas and talk about Oklahoma City, I tell them that this is the most caring city in the world, and they say, how do you know that? I said, I know it by personal experience. If you look at London bombing, if you look at any of the bombing, Madrid bombing, Mumbai bombing, Africa bombing, people are running away from the bombing site as fast as possible. Only Oklahoma City, not even World Trade Center. People are flocking towards the bombing site, trying to help people. There are people that are hurt with the rubble while trying to rescue people. That's the kind of people we have. So I talk about the inner resilience that human beings have. How do you tap into that? How do you put it to use when you face adversity, when you face loss, when you face change, and when you're facing overwhelming, you know, bad things happen to you? How do you find that inner strength and become vibrant? Not only heal and become whole, but become vibrant. That means you infuse your energy, your creativity, and your own passion to those around you and to the community around you.
From India to Oklahoma City.
That's right.
So talk about yourself real quick. You were born where?
I was born in India.
And you came here when?
1975.
And you've been in Oklahoma City ever since?
Ever since.
How many years? You've been there forever.
It's about 38.
38 years.
This is your home.
This is my home.
And you defend it so well.
Oh, yeah. He was 7 years old when he came.
Yeah.
My daughter was born here. My son was 3 years old when I came here from England. Mm-hmm. And my 4 grandchildren are born here. I have only one condition for my children and grandchildren and the students I teach. Come back to Oklahoma. Stay in Oklahoma.
Absolutely.
Settle in Oklahoma.
That's a great message.
Yeah. This is the most caring community that you have in the world.
He should run for mayor or governor.
Maybe he will.
Where's the money go? People are going to buy this book. Where's the money go?
The money goes to eliminating the stigma of mental illness award that my family instituted. Integris Foundation has set up an escrow account, and that money will go there. to help eliminate the stigma of mental illness from the world. And we're making a lot of progress. We have annual NAMI walk in support of the mentally ill. There used to be just a few hundred people. Now with the support from this award and many other activities many of our friends did, there are almost 2,000 people coming to that NAMI walk nowadays. It's like a giant family reunion. We don't have to be ashamed about the brain diseases.
And even like Alzheimer's.
You're right, absolutely.
Right. Family members.
So there is a stigma.
There is stigma.
All right. Dr. Morali Krishna has been our guest. He's the president of the Oklahoma State Board of Health, as we talked about the tobacco bill, the smoking local control bill out at the state capitol. We'll continue to follow that, and good luck with your book.
Thank you, Kevin.
And tell Dr. Klein hello.
Thank you. Appreciate it, Mike. Thank
great
you
to see you, Morali.
Thanks.
Thank you. We'll be back to wrap things up on Flashpoint. Thanks.
Applying for Social Security disability is complicated and time-consuming. Initial applications are routinely denied, requiring you to file for what's known as reconsideration. If that's denied, the next step is a hearing before a judge, although sometimes a hearing can be avoided if the proper evidence is submitted. Each year, Ryan Bisher Ryan, one of the state's largest Social Security law firms, handles hundreds of claims throughout the state of Oklahoma. For over 25 years, when hurt people need help, they call us, Ryan Bisher Ryan.
This new Corolla is loaded, moonroof, in-tune multimedia, even has a navigation system, and it's one of our newest colors, the Barcelona Red.
I got my mother's eyes, my father's hands, and in about 10 years, I'll get my brother's Corolla.
Corollas last. 80% of Corollas sold in the last 20 years are still on the road. Right now, get $1,000 customer cash or 0% APR for 60 months on the 2013 Toyota Corolla. Toyota. Let's go places.
As a three-year-old boy that loves to go to school and play with his friends, and looking at him, you would never know how sick he's been. Having expert doctors in a range of fields has honestly made the difference in life and death for my son that I'm not sure that anyone else could have done for him what OU Medicine has done for him. My son is alive and well.
Own Truck Month. As Oklahomans, we earn it every day. You see, more people trust Ford F-Series for the toughest jobs. Across this country, we own work. And they come in handy on weekends, too. Working hard, even when you're not. During Truck Month, get a stampede of savings on the number one brand 36 years running, including Ford F-150 with up to $7,500 in total savings at your Oklahoma Ford dealer. Check the facts at FordWeOwnWork.com.
Okay.
Kirk?
I want to say congratulations to three newly elected members of Oklahoma City School Board. They'll take office tomorrow. Mm-hmm. Lynn Harden's the new chairman, Justin Ellis, and Bob Hammock. Congratulations.
And we appreciate Angela Monson's service to the school board.
Yeah, she did a good job. Hey, Bob Hammock is one creative guy. New ideas create new realities. Get ready.
Okay.
And happy 90th birthday to Hugh Madewell over in Jones, Oklahoma.
Wow. That's 90 right. years he was Madewell.
Isn't that something? Yeah, Hugh Madewell. And they brought Dr. Terry Klein back from, what'd you say? Baghdad?
Baghdad.
He's doing a good job. Thank you.